the perfect summer makeup finds, half aprons, rose geranium essential oil, and apple cider vinegar gummies? Welcome to the June edition of Connoisseur Reviews. My name is Jennifer and welcome back to The Daily Connoisseur. I do a once a month review video on my channel where I try to curate things that this community would be interested in. This month I have a wonderful selection of items to share with you. We're really going to be getting into some makeup in this edition as I do like to change my makeup as the seasons change. So make yourself a cup of tea and join me for this edition of Connoisseur Reviews. I've actually reviewed this already on my channel. I think it was about this time last year. But it's the Osmosis CC Cream Foundation, and I found myself returning to it again for this summer. I ran out, I used the whole thing, and then I continued to use heavier foundations through the winter, such as my favorite Adele foundations, as well as some Bare Minerals foundations that I like. As we go towards summer, I love to use a CC cream, so I thought I'd bring it up again here, just in case you missed my previous review. So Osmosis CC Cream is a radiance-enhancing, color-correcting makeup foundation, and it really transforms the skin. What I love about it most is that it goes on kind of clear, and then it molds to the color of your skin. They do have different skin tone shades that you can choose. So I use the shade warm, for example, and you know, I have slightly tan skin, not too dark, but not too fair. I'm kind of in the middle there. So warm really works well for me. It's just one of those great creams that you could just pump in your hands, put it on your skin, and just maybe put a little finishing powder on top. It's very lightweight. It's not a heavy foundation that's really going to be kind of stifling in the summer months. So this is something that I have returned to, and I really enjoy it, and I will leave it linked for you down below. Okay, the next makeup item I wanted to talk to you about is this Aether, and I think I'm pronouncing that correctly. Aether makeup palette. And I found this on Grove Collaborative because they now offer makeup. Aether palette has 12 cosmic inspired shades in ultra matte, shimmer, duochrome, and metallic finishes that lets you create looks that enhance your natural beauty. This is a description from the palette. This is a nice eyeshadow palette that has unique and ethereal shades. So one thing that you should take note of, and I wasn't sure about this, I chose this particular palette, and I believe this is the Amethyst Crystal Gemstone palette because I have green eyes and I like to wear purple shades to bring out the green in my eyes. So something that I was actually surprised about is that every single shade here is dark. There is not a lot of contrast. Usually when you get a makeup palette, like an eyeshadow palette, you will have some lighter shades, some medium tone shades, and then some dark shades. So it is important to note that there are no light shades and hardly even any medium shades in this palette. They're all dark shades. So if you want to create a blended look, because I like to put on a light shade and then a darker shade, you will have to use another eyeshadow in order to do that. So that is something to note. I don't know if that's going to be something that turns you off on the palette or not. Maybe you just have a standard vanilla shade that you always put on. But the dark shades that they do have are very pretty, and they are very cosmic, and like I said, some of them are metallic and some of them are matte. When I first started using the makeup palette, I was a bit surprised that they were all so dark, and I had some really dark smoky eyes when I first started using the palette because I wasn't really aware of the fact that they were all so dark. So I actually think that this makeup palette would be better for fall, winter because the shades are so dark, but they are buildable. Okay, the next makeup that I would like to talk to you about is the NYX or NYX retractable eyeliner. So I have always for years used the Chanel Amber eyeliner, the Kohl eyeliner. And because of the lockdown, I usually just go to Macy's to get it, but I hadn't been to Macy's. So, and it's really hard to find it online. So I didn't buy it and I ran out of it. So I just went on Amazon and I looked for their most popular eyeliners, the ones with the best reviews, and this was it. And it's very affordable, a lot more affordable than the Chanel one that I usually use. Here are the great things about this eyeliner. Number one, it's very easy to apply. It goes on very smoothly. It's very creamy, it's not drying, and I like that a lot. Also, it's waterproof. It doesn't go anywhere all day. Doesn't matter what you do. And my Chanel one would rub off as the day went on. So this one is very waterproof. It is easy to take off. I find that I have to use a makeup remover cloth in order to do so. Another plus about it is that it is retractable, so you don't need a pencil. So I really disliked sharpening my older eyeliner with a pencil. One of the cons is for me that it is very dark, so maybe I'll try one of their other shades, but it is a very dark color. This is just brown, and I think the reason why I like to use browns and burgundies is because they are less harsh for my eyes. I have a hooded eye, so I've always wanted to do winged eyeliner, but that has just never quite worked for me. So I do like to use more subtle shades on my eyes. But all in all, I can really recommend this retractable eyeliner from NYX. I think that it is great and it is very affordable, and I've been using it for the past month or so and I enjoy it. Okay, so that is it for the makeup. I would love to know if you have any makeup recommendations for us in today's video. Just leave them in the comments down below. Okay, next I want to talk to you about apple cider vinegar gummies. Yes, you heard that right, gummies. The people from Goli emailed me and I was immediately intrigued because I do take apple cider vinegar on a regular basis, but I have a major problem with the taste. It almost makes me gag. I can't stand it. And I do take the apple cider vinegar with the mother. That's the important thing about the health benefits of apple cider vinegar. But Goli created these gummies that have the mother in them. So let me share with you what this has and the benefits of it. So I've been taking them for the past 3 weeks or so. I take two every day and I really like these gummies. They're great. So these are the benefits in comparison. It says appetite control and weight loss. Now, I don't take these for that, but apparently that's a benefit that you get from both traditional apple cider vinegar and the gummies. They lower blood sugar levels, they improve your immune system, they are both made with the mother, which is great. They contain highly nutritious acetic acid. And then this is what the gummies have that traditional apple cider doesn't have, okay? So they are infused with superfoods like pomegranate and beetroot. They are enriched with vitamins B9 and B12. They're safe for your tooth enamel. They taste good. They have a yummy smell. And they're easy to take. So I can definitely vouch for that. I like taking these. In fact, I look forward to it. I'm one of those people who loves gummies. Like if I were to choose candy, I would choose a gummy candy, gummy bears, that type of thing. So I do love a good gummy. They're gluten-free, vegan, non-GMO, organic, and unfiltered. So I just really like these. If you take apple cider vinegar on a daily basis, but you can't stand the taste, it makes you gag, you try to choke down your water like I have been doing, you might like these. I will leave them down below along with my coupon code. Okay, let's talk about scented things because you know I love scents. I'm so strongly attracted to scents. So the first thing I want to talk about briefly, because I'm actually going to do a dedicated video on the topic, is a new perfume company that I have discovered called Pinrose. So I'm not going to go into it too much here, but I wanted to kind of bring it up in case you wanted to look into it. They have sample packs that you can order where you can sample their perfumes. So I will leave that down below so that by the time I do my dedicated review, you might be on the same page with me if you want to sample some of these scents. But I was completely blown away by this perfume. I have just had such a hard time finding something that I like since I've had children. So they give you a little quiz on Pinrose. And Pinrose is basically, this is how they describe themselves, whimsical fragrances free of toxic chemicals that no woman wants touching her skin. Leveraged by the psychology of smell and synesthesia, I can't say that, synesthesia, we elicit sensory responses that make each of us one of a kind for the woman who aspires to be no one in the world but herself. So true. So I took the quiz, and based on that quiz, they sent me what my scent profile was, and I was completely blown away with the scents that they sent me. They were perfect. Normally, I'll try something and I'll think, okay, this is good, but there's just a little element to it that makes me kind of nauseous, or, you know, there's something. With this one, I've actually found a few that I can't stop thinking about, and I've been wearing them. So, again, I'm gonna go into this in a separate video, but the scent profile that I chose, apparently it chose for me, was called Secret Genius, which is Madagascar Vanilla Caramel and Sandalwood. It's just so good for fall. I'm holding up the little scent sachets, by the way. Mystical Misfit was one that they just sent me to try. Peach Berry and Patchouli, so good for summer. This one's Sun Saint. This is Sea Salt, Coconut, and Lime. I'm also looking forward to trying their Pin Rose scent. So I am going to be going more in depth into that, but this is a company that is really cool, and you can try out the samples of perfumes without committing to buying a big bottle, just to see if you like them. So I will leave them down below. Okay, well, next, if you saw my homemaking video from last week, I was making rose scented floor cleaner. Yes, and so my friends at Mirapure Essential Oils created this rose geranium scent. I actually contacted them and I said, do you have a rose scent? Because I want to recreate the Mrs. Meyer's rose cleaning products that are no longer available because they sold out. And so they sent me this, and this scent is so good and accurate. Sometimes a rose scent, especially with geranium, can make me a little nauseous. It might be, you know, synthetic smelling. But this is just a beautiful scented rose essential oil. I really love it. Let's see what they say here. The benefits are that it is a sedative, insect repellent, natural astringent, and it blends really well with lavender, clary sage, orange, lemon, bergamot, lemongrass, clove, and grapefruit. And the way they collect it is through steam distillation from the leaves and flowers of the plants originating in South Africa. So this is a really great essential oil, and I highly recommend it. So I will leave it down below from Mirapure. And finally, I wanted to talk to you about the half aprons that I have. My friend Shay Elliott from the Elliott Homestead. And by the way, I was a guest on the Homemaker Chic podcast that Shay does with Angela from Parisian Farm Girl. And you've got to check out our conversation. It's so good. I'll leave it linked down below. But Shay likes to wear half aprons. I love the half apron look. Sometimes I need that because the reason why I wear aprons, number one, is to protect my clothing. But number two, because I'm always listening to audiobooks and things like that with my phone tucked into a pocket and headphones in my ears. So I love these two half aprons. I got them both on Amazon, and I think that they work really well for what I've tried to do. So I'm gonna leave those linked down below as well. I hope that you enjoyed this June edition of Connoisseur Reviews. Thank you so much for joining me today on The Daily Connoisseur. If you have any requests for future reviews, please leave them down in the comment section below. That is it for Connoisseur Reviews for June. Thank you so much for joining me today on The Daily Connoisseur. And if you have anything that you would like me to review in a future video, please let me know down below in the comment section. Thank you very much, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.